Today, I would like to talk about the new AI chip that is breaking all the speed records. And the best part about it, that it's fully designed and manufactured in the US. As a chip designer, I was very curious to know if this chip is as good as it cracked up to be or just hype. Let's find out. First of all, previously I've discussed the trend that the future of computing is in custom silicon. And here it is. Grok chip is an ASIC, application-specific integrated circuit, specifically designed for language processing. Have a look at this silicon die. It's born and raised in the US, rival to NVIDIA. While all other AI chips designed by NVIDIA, AMD, Intel, Google, and Tesla, they're highly dependent on manufacturing and packaging technology by TSMC. And this one is entirely domestic design and manufacturing. So to say 100% American, it's manufactured at global foundries at 14 nanometers. And 14 nanometer process is quite a mature technology, which makes it more robust and much cheaper to fabricate. However, Grok is already working on the next version, the next generation of their chip, which will be fabricated by Samsung in 4 nanometers at the new Samsung factory at Texas. Now, let me explain the Grok benchmarks everyone is talking about and how exactly they were achieved. And spoiler, the inference speed is truly fantastic. You know, when I'm having a conversation with ChatGPT, I often have to wait 3 to 5 seconds for a response. And that's because the GPT model runs on Microsoft Azure Cloud powered by NVIDIA GPUs. And the speed at which I'm getting the response mostly depends on the speed of those GPUs and their latency. 3 to 5 seconds is very slow. It's a delay that everyone can easily notice. Just imagine for a moment if I would start to talk so slow. Everyone would drop off immediately. Grok took open source Mixtral AI model and accelerated it on their hardware to make it a better user experience. I was testing it in chat mode and I get a response in less than a quarter of a second. These are the official benchmarks that compare different AI inference services running the same Mixtral model. Here is Perplexity, running on NVIDIA GPUs through Amazon Cloud, and it costs about 25 cents per 1 million tokens and has a throughput of 150 tokens per second. We obviously want the highest throughput at the lowest price. You can see that there is one big outlier, Grok, which costs about 30 cents per 1 million tokens and delivers about 430 tokens per second. And if we take the average here, Grok system is on average 4 to 5 times faster than any of the inference services listed here. According to another official benchmark, Meta's Llama 2, which is 70 billion parameters model, while running on Grok system, is up to 18 times faster than GPU-based cloud providers. Clearly, these benchmarks have generated a lot of excitement around Grok's hardware. Now it's time to understand how it was achieved and how it compares to other AI accelerators. So have a look at the layout. That's the layout of the Grok 1 chip. You may have noticed that there are many thousands of repeating blocks which appear to resemble solar cells. Now, why do you care? So why does this chip layout deserve your attention? Because it has something that most of the modern AI accelerators don't have. All of its memory is on the chip. This is similar in a way to Cerebras chip design, but in the case of Cerebras chip, the memory and the cores are intertwined. While NVIDIA GPUs, on the other hand, always come with a huge off-chip memory. Actually, there are 2 to 3 main advantages of having on-chip memory. First of all, this close coupling, close location of matrix unit and the memory helps to minimize the latency. And this explains why everyone who is trying Grok hardware seeing such an amazing latency. As you can see on this figure, Grok's hardware is outstanding across the board. With 430 tokens per second at 0.3 of a second latency, it's clearly amazingly quick when it comes to response to prompts. Let me know what you think. The second advantage of having on-chip memory is that this chip doesn't require expensive and hard-to-get advanced packaging technology. Grok doesn't depend on the memory chips from Korean Xinx or on COWOS packaging technology from TSMC. This makes it much cheaper for Grok to manufacture their silicon. More mature process node means lower costs per wafer and per die, and no fancy packaging means they don't have to pay for this and they can stick to domestic manufacturing offerings. And all of this gives them such a rare flexibility to switch between fabs. They just migrated from GlobalFoundries to the Samsung fab to migrate to the lower and more advanced process node. On the left side of the chip, you can see the matrix unit, which is the chip's main workhorse. And the same matrix unit is also on the right side of the chip. And each millimeter square of this chip is capable of 1 tera operations per second. The matrix unit is followed by the memory and the vector unit. And these units are passing the results between each other. So you can stream the data from east to the west of the chip, as well as the other way around. As much as I love the silicon part of the Grok chip, overall the performance is achieved by co-designing software and hardware, so the complete stack. Now, although Grok is selling their chips, their business model is mostly focused around inference as a service. And that's very interesting. You know, training AI models is a one-time problem. And computing power is getting cheaper and cheaper. But inference is a constant problem. And it's inherently larger market than training. And the most important thing that it scales very well. As more users, more businesses, and more people are starting to use generative AI. So companies like Mistral and Meta are building open source AI models. And then Grok is accelerating these models on their hardware for other companies that want to use these open source AI models in their applications. Talking about the perspective of this chip, we need to keep in mind the market. How big is it? Yes, there is a Amazon Cloud, and then there is a Microsoft Azure Cloud, which OpenAI is using to run their models on. And then there is also Google Cloud, and Google DeepMind can run their inference on Google's infrastructure. But what about middle and small businesses? They need to run their model somewhere, right? That's the market that Grok is addressing, and it's huge, and it's growing. However, Grok's inference services are reportedly not yet profitable. And to make it profitable, they are planning on scaling the throughput per chip and also number of chips to 1 million by the end of 2024. Grok claims that they will be able to break even by the end of 2024. I think it's possible if they are able to scale up fast enough to keep up with the pace of AI development. In fact, right now is a perfect time for this chip because this speed and latency, the super fast speed and latency, might be game changing for many applications. If we are talking of chatbots and voice assistants, this speed advantage can make a huge difference because it can make all this interaction to feel more natural. So, congratulations! Now it's going to be even harder to distinguish an AI agent from a real person. Now, let's discuss some of the concerns. For a model like Mistral, which is 50 billion parameters model, the Grok chip architecture looks great. A large language model like Mistral with about 50 billion parameters requires 578 Grok chips to run it. For comparison, the same Mistral model can fit on 2 NVIDIA H100 GPUs. And now you might be thinking, wait, how this is gonna scale when we come to 1 trillion or 10 trillion parameter models? Actually, this is a question that should be asked of any AI accelerator. How well can you scale? The thing is, Croc has on-chip memory only, which has a lot of pros we discussed, but it also has its cons. Fast forward in the future, for a 10 trillion parameters model, we would need tens of terabytes of memory. And if we recalculate it back to the Groq chip, which has 220 megabytes of memory per chip, it would require Groq to scale to tens or hundreds of thousands of Groq chips, which are networked together. And then just think about the distribution of the load between them and networking them in a way to achieve the same low latency. That's gonna be challenging, if it's even feasible at all. Let me know what you think in the comments. And before we talk about Groq's chip competition and my outlook, I would like to ask you, if you're enjoying this video, please consider subscribing to the channel and sharing this video with friends and your colleagues who might be interested. This helps the channel more than you know. Thank you. Speaking of scaling and competition, Groq's architecture is quite different from the rest. From AI accelerators made by NVIDIA, Google, Tesla, Moore's Rat, Huawei, and so on. But it somewhat resembles Cerebras wafer scale engine. And their chip has also on-chip memory that is distributed around the cores. The thing is, Cerebras' single chip is 46,225 millimeters square of silicon. It occupies the entire 300 millimeter wafer. Just to give you a feeling, such a 300 millimeter wafer could accommodate 65 Groq chips. Cerebras' architecture seems to scale better. And although they are providing inference services, they're mostly focusing on selling their hardware, so building infrastructure for other companies. And if we continue to talk about the competition of Groq, it's obviously the main AI horse of the world today, NVIDIA GPUs. From all these specs, benchmarks, and numbers I was able to find, Groq is able to outperform NVIDIA GPUs like H100 in latency and costs per million tokens. But not yet at throughput, but they're working on it. And keep in mind that very soon, in a month or so, NVIDIA will be presenting their new B100 GPU, which will be taped out in 3 nanometers. And that's very exciting, because we can expect double the performance of H100 GPU. In my opinion, Groq is a very promising startup along with Cerebras, but their success depends on their development of their software stack and also on their next generation 4 nanometer chip. Keep in mind that all the metrics we discussed today are achieved by their older 14 nanometer chip, which is from about 2 years ago, and it took them some time to build the whole system, the whole stack, to make it up and running. So with their next 4 nanometer design, they will increase several X's in speed and power efficiency. And we are definitely living in a very exciting times, guys. Some years ago, we talked about CPUs and GPUs. Then we talked about NPUs, neural processing unit. And now Groq calls their LPU, language processing unit. These are specifically tailored for handling natural language processing tasks. And ASIC everything is definitely the trend of this century. Thank you so much for watching and for supporting this channel. Ciao.